Welcome to the fourth session of this video series. In this session, we will be focusing on ARP protocol. So we will be analyzing the ARP protocol. So far, if you observe all the previous sessions, we were analyzing packets. Now we'll start focusing on the protocol, in the sense like what is the packet that is generated, and in response to that, what is the packet coming back. So to start off with, so let's have a look at the various addresses that a host will have. So basically, in the data link layer, the physical and data link layer, they will be identified by a physical address, and then the network layer, basically the IP protocol, that will be identified with a logical address. And then basically the transport layer, they will be associated with port addresses, and finally the applications, they'll be associated with specific addresses. Let's give an example here. So physical addresses is basically, one of the examples is the MAC address. So every host whichever has an interface to the network will have a unique MAC address or unique physical address. And then an example of logical addresses is the IP address. So these two put together, this IP address and the MAC address put together, uniquely identify the host on the network. So to understand this clearly, one analogy that we can take is that individuals have names to them, associated to them. So each individual has a name. So basically we can say, just taking the analogy, name is like the physical address of an individual, and that is permanent with him. So wherever the individual goes, he has this name doesn't change. Then the logical address, the analogy of the logical address, the roll number that each individual will have. So roll number, for example, students have their roll numbers, or employees have their employee number. So roll number is the logical address. So basically, why is logical address given? Because in an institute, for example, in a college, it's easier to locate a individual by his roll number. So for example, any message comes or any person comes to meet a individual. So just telling the name to the security at the entrance, it will be difficult for the security to identify the individual. So rather, if the roll number is used, the security can immediately point out, because roll number has logic inside that. From the roll number, the individual can be identified which department he belongs to, ECE or CSE. So that particular person who has the visitor can be sent to the respective department, that it has been identified that the roll number belongs to ECE. So he comes to ECE department. And again, looking at the roll number in ECE department, the visitor can be guided to which floor, which section, and all those things. So the individuals can be easily identified by the roll numbers, because roll numbers have logic inside them, and this will help basically to route the visitors to the right individual. The same thing happens with IP address. IP addresses are given to individual nodes or individual hosts, and these are given by the network that they currently belong to. Just like the way roll number is given when a student joins a particular college, a roll number is given to him. And likewise, when the student leaves that college and goes to another college, he gets another roll number over there, which is specific to that particular college. The same thing happens here. The IP address is given by the network, and it is local to that. It is given to the individual host, as long as the host is there inside that network, so that it can be identified. And when this host moves away from this network, goes to another network, so he gets the IP address from the new network that he has moved into. So that's the analogy. So having said that, IP address is a logical address. So now the ARP protocol, address resolution protocol, what it does is it helps the IP layer to identify the physical address given the IP address. So once the IP address, basically IP address is known, so ARP helps in resolving this IP address or finding out which machine is currently holding this IP address, a particular IP address, or which machine, or what is the physical address of the machine, what is the physical address of the, or the MAC address of the machine, which is holding this IP address. So that is where ARP comes in. So you can see that IP gives the IP address to ARP, and ARP is supposed to broadcast on the network and then find out which machine is currently holding this IP address, get the MAC address of it, and give it back to the IP protocol. That's the purpose of the ARP. Let's look at it pictorially. Pictorially, we can see that first the ARP request goes out. So basically, for example, we have four systems here, system A, system B. Likewise, there is one more system here, there is one more system here. And let's assume that each of them have their the physical address or the data link address called as L1, and network address, that is the logical address, called as N1. Likewise, this has L2, N2, and this has L3 and N3, and vice versa. Likewise, it has L4 and N4. So now let's assume that this system wants to find out, basically it's looking for the physical address or the link address of a node which currently is holding the IP address N2. So what the ARP protocol does is, first it sends a request, and since he doesn't know the physical address who is holding N2, this request is basically a broadcast request. So you can see that it is being broadcast to everybody. A copy of that is reaching system B, likewise it is also reaching system 3 and system 4. So basically ARP's request will be broadcast, and then basically everybody gets a request. And now since system B is holding, or system 2 is holding, the N2 network address, only he responds back. So you can see in the responses, right now in the responses you can see that system B is replying back. And who is it replying back? It is replying back to the system that has asked, or who has generated the request. That is, in this case, system A has generated that request. So only to that it will be replying back. So what will be the reply? It will basically be saying, I am the node and my link address is L2. So basically, so here you can see that he was requesting, saying that who is holding N2, and N2 is being held by this guy. So this guy is responding back with a reply saying that I am holding N2 and my physical address is L2. And that's the reply. That's how the system A gets to know the physical address, that is the physical address of system B as L2. And then looking at the packet structure. So packet structure, it has various fields. Hardware type is basically 16 bits, protocol type, and likewise all those fields are there. We'll see them shortly. And then in the operations, you can see in the this is the opcode that will be used. So request, when the request is going out, this opcode will be set as 1. And when a response is coming back, this opcode will be set back to 2. That is, 2 will indicate it is a reply. Then let's get into practical, and then let's note down this detail as well. Just before starting the Wireshark, let me just bring it to one side. Let's get into the machine, the laptop that I am working on. Yeah, let's open the command prompt and let's note down few details over here. In fact, just note that this command prompt, I have started it with administrative access. So we'll be using few commands that will require administrative access. So to start a command prompt with administrative access, all you need to do is from the start menu, command prompt is here, right click on it and say run as administrator. Instead of just clicking on it directly, you should say right click and say run as administrator. That's when you will get this command prompt with special rights. So right now we want to note down these details. Current machine's IP address, then its MAC address, default gateway it is using, and that default gateway MAC address. So the way to figure this out is we use ipconfig/all. We use this command, so we'll get all these details here. Yeah, it is giving me the details. The IP address currently that I am using is .9. Okay, let's note it down. The IP address of my machine is 192.168.10.9, and the MAC address, this is where the MAC address is displayed, basically 48 bit MAC address. It is 0C7A, then 15CC F1A5. This is the MAC address of my machine. And then likewise, let's also note down the default gateway's IP address, which is here, the mouse is pointing to 192.168.10.1. And then you can see that there is no, we also want to note down the MAC address of the gateway, but that is not there, that is not displayed over here. In fact, it will be there in the ARP table. So let's type the ARP command, ARP minus A. So here we can see this is a ARP table that my laptop has already figured out. It has figured out that this IP address has this MAC address. So how did it find out that this is a MAC address? That is where ARP has been used. So let's clear this table, and in a short time we'll see that ARP will again populate this. So while it is populating, let's do one thing. Let's also in the background, let's start the Wireshark. So I have kept the, you can see I have kept the filter as ARP, no packets are arriving now. So what I'll do is I'll open the command prompt, and then I am right now clearing the ARP table. ARP minus D is the command to clear it. So I have cleared it. Let me clear it again. And you can see some packets scrolling in the background in the Wireshark. Let's look at the ARP table now. So ARP table might have already been populated. Okay. So right now you can see it has not been populated by .1. So in a short span, it will be populated. Or to force it to populate it, we can open a browser and we type any URL that we want. For example, our college ID, I'm typing MGAT. And definitely this traffic should have gone through the gateway. And for it to go through the gateway, my machine should know the MAC address of the gateway, and definitely it should have done a broadcast and found out the MAC address of my gateway. Now you can see in the ARP table that the gateway's MAC address has been found out and it has been displayed over here. So 10.1 is having this physical address or the MAC address. So let's also note it down. We had one entry corresponding to it. So the MAC address is F4 F2 6D, 69, D0, and AA. Okay. Now let's get back to Wireshark and analyze these packets. Let's get back to this is where our Wireshark is. And let's see those requests, the broadcast requests that are going out. So interestingly, look at this packet. Look at this packet. And or one second, let's look at this packet, a broadcast packet basically. So from here we can see that ARP protocol is just carried by the Ethernet frame. And look at the contents of this ARP packet. Let's also keep noting the values down. So just moving to the next field. So the request, we are observing the request now. So look at the request field. So this is in the third pane. We can see that the portion where the ARP header and the data is. So clicking on this, hardware type is basically taking 16 bits and it's carrying a content of 0001, and then protocol type, it's again 16 bits and it has 0800, indicating that it is IPv4, and one indicates that it is Ethernet, and 08 indicates it is of type IPv4. And then hardware size 8 bits, and it is carrying 06. And then likewise protocol size is basically 8 bits again, and it is carrying a value of 04. And then opcode, like we saw the opcode is basically 16 bits and it is carrying a value of 0001, indicating that this is request. And then look at the MAC address, sender's MAC address. And if you observe now, this is totally 6 into 8, that is 48 bits. And you can see 0C, these are hexadecimal, 0C, 7A, 15, CC, F1, and then A5. And if you observe this from the previous table, this is basically my MAC addresses. The MAC address of our machine is being populated here. And then the source IP, you can see that when we see the source IP, you can see that it is 4 into 8, that is basically 32 bits. And we'll note down the IP address in my dotted decimal, the 192.168.10. So this is the IP address of our machine. Then after that, look at the target MAC address. So target MAC address, it doesn't know the target MAC address. That's the reason this request is populating the target MAC address as all zeros. It is populating it as all zeros. And then IP address, we can see, sorry, this is not 32, this is 48 bits. And then the destination or the target IP address, we can see that it is 32 bits in length. And then who is it brought? Basically, it is asking that who has this 192.168.10.1. And observe that this ARP, when it is sent in the Ethernet packet, and look at the destination address. Destination address is filled up as all Fs. So Ethernet packet destination, Ethernet packet destination MAC has been filled up as FF. So all ones basically, indicating that it is a broadcast address which is supposed to be picked up by everybody. It is picked up by everybody. It is supposed to be picked up by everybody. So now looking at the second packet after that. So we were basically looking at it's continuously scrolling, so we had kept it as on, so it's continuously scrolling. Let's go back up. Yeah, this was the packet we were looking at. And then after that we can see that dot one has responded back. So it has responded back. Let's look at the, I'm clicking at dot one now. Let's look at the contents of the dot one now. So let's get back to the values that we need to note down. Yeah, we are now focusing on the reply message. In the reply message, again, if you see all these fields, in fact, hardware type and protocol type, hardware length, we can all note it down from here. The interesting things to observe here in opcode is one thing. Yeah, look at the opcode is now basically carrying 2, indicating that it is a reply. Previously it was 1, saying that it is request. And now look at the MAC addresses here. So look at the sender's IP address is, sender IP address or the source IP address is 192.168.10.1. That is the gateway is responding back, and he is also sending his MAC address. He is sending his MAC address saying that this is my MAC address F2 60 69 D0 and AA. And of course, if you observe, this will be 32 bits. This will be 32 bits. And destination MAC will be 48 bits. And destination source will be 32 bits. Now you can see the gateway has responded back to 192.168.10.9, which is our laptop here. And it has also populated the MAC address of our laptop. So this is the MAC address of our laptop, F1.AFI. And the other thing to observe now is basically the Ethernet packet. Now look at the destination, the request or the response is now coming back to the specific machine, that is the specific MAC address, and this is the MAC address of my machine. So what have we seen now? Just concluding. We generated ARP network traffic using the browser, through the HTTP browser. We forced the MAC address of the gateway to be discovered using ARP. Then we captured it in Wireshark. We set the appropriate display filter as the ARP. Then we looked at the ARP headers, both the request and the reply packets. Request, we saw that it was a broadcast message going to everybody, and reply was a specific message coming back to my machine from the gateway with the MAC address of the gateway. So we'll end here. Thank you. See you in the next video session.